you very much, everyone, for being here tonight. You just heard Magna Cum Laude by Jerry Billick. And how do I put this? That march is just a little bit intense. And that's just the way I like it. I can think about three marches that I'd like to play again. This one for sure. Our resident composer, Gene Conley's March of the Bison, and of course the Imperial March, you know, from Star Wars, the one where Darth Vader goes around slashing people with lightsabers. Those are my kind of marches. So you guys just heard a bunch of exciting sounds, which are our theme tonight for tonight's concert. Some of the exciting sounds that you heard were some very thick harmonies with lots of low and high notes all at the same time. Basically, if you sum those up, it's like very scary chords. You also heard some beautiful counterpoint, some melodies that were in juxtaposition to each other between the clarinets and flutes against the French horns and trombones. And also, you heard a lot of parallel fifths. Now, any of you who ever took a music theory class, you learned back in the classical period that those parallel fifths were a big no-no. They're essentially the equivalent of taking a power chord shape on guitar and just moving it up and down around the neck to create the different chords without changing your shape at all. It's not very subtle. It is very powerful and very awesome. So I'm not sure why they didn't like it in the 1700s, but we like it now. All right, so next we're gonna play a piece by Leonard Bernstein. And it is from his ballet, Fancy Free. I had actually never seen the ballet, and after playing this piece, I would very much like to see it. If we had dancers on stage, without some really well-prepared choreography, they would get off step very easily. There's times in our music you'll hear, and I want you guys to keep your ears out for this, where we have, instead of our regular 4-4 or 4-beat count, we're gonna have a random measure of 2 or a random measure of 3, and it sounds like the music is glitching or resetting. It's actually a very smooth glitch, but it's still, you know, it's like, I'm in the Matrix, what's happening? And so listen for that. We also have some wonderful solos and solis. You're gonna hear piccolo, flute, oboe, sax, and trumpet, and woodblock. So listen carefully for that woodblock. Here is Leonard Bernstein's Danzon. Thank you. Yeah, thanks for the shout out there, little man or woman. Alrighty. So next we're gonna play a piece by Alan Havanas, and it has a fun title, Mysterious Mountain. It is a very appropriate title. It is a gorgeous song, and also, yes, very mysterious. So some of the things that build the mystery in this piece that I want you to listen for. You will hear at times where it sounds like one part of the band is in one key or scale, and then another part is in a mysteriously different key or scale. So for example, at the beginning of the piece here, you're going to hear the winds playing these lush, beautiful chords, and then the piano and the bass are going to be playing this kind of thumping, walking along bass line, but it's very chromatic and it sounds like it explores other keys in what the band's playing, and it helps add some mystery to the piece. And stuff like that happens all throughout the piece. We'll also hear some celeste, which is a beautiful bell-like keyboard that we don't get to hear very often in concerts, so that's exciting. And I hope you like it. Here is Mysterious Mountain.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Well, I'm looking here at my notes for the things I'm going to say, and I totally skipped a song. So I don't have a lot to say about this next song. It's very rhythmic. It has a fun name, Kaleidoscope. And anybody have anything exciting from the band? Nope? Okay. You guys can tell me what's exciting about it, all right, after you listen to it. Hopefully that was enough time for the percussion to get all set up for our next piece. Here's Kaleidoscope. say anything. It was really exciting. Okay, guys, thank you all for being here. Before we play our last number for you, I would like to tell you about some upcoming events we have. If you look at the back of your program, you'll see that next week, it's free jazz. You'll see that next week we have a concert outside on Thursday at 6 o'clock, and it will feature some of our jazz groups and some of our vocal groups, and it should be fantastic. The week after that, on a Wednesday night, if you want to head downtown to the restaurant slash club Brick House, you'll get to hear jazz bands, our jazz groups from CSI playing from 6 to 9, which should be very fun. Also, on November 17th, in the recital hall here at 7:30, I will be having my own jazz group, and we'll be playing, and we'll be celebrating the release of a new recording that we did, so that'll be exciting. And then this band, along with the jazz ensemble, the big band, has a big concert on December 8th at 7:30 p.m. And we'd love for you to come to every single one, and if you're not there, we're going to cry a lot. Okay, so some other thank yous. I wanted to thank you guys for coming. I wanted to thank our band for all their hard work. I wanted to thank whoever gave me this white glove so that the band could see my hand better. Very much appreciated. Yeah, okay. Let's see. Let's thank Dan and Megan, who are running our sound, lights, and streaming, please. Yay. Thanks, guys. And then also, we'll just thank the college for hosting our concert, giving us a beautiful performance space and a rehearsal space and all of those nice things. So thanks. All right. So, last but not least, we have one more exciting sound for you, and that is the Carmen Suite by George Bizet. This is a collection of 4 movements featuring lots of different iconic themes from his famous opera, Carmen. It has a Spanish tinge. The opera's actually set in Spain, and George Bizet was very familiar with Spanish culture and music because he visited there a lot, even though he was from France. Anyways, it's super fun to play, and I know the band would tell you that because they always get really excited when we rehearse this, at least most of them do. Anyways, while we play, go ahead and listen for all the songs that you recognize. I'm sure there will be at least one, if not like 20. So thank you again for coming, guys. Here's our last piece. Thank you.
Thank you.